स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? दिस इज पूजा परिहार, योर इंग्लिश टीचर फ्रॉम आर्डन प्रोग्रेसिव स्कूल लामाचो, एंड आई होप दैट यू ऑल आर फिट एंड फाइन एंड हेल्दी एट योर होम्स एंड टेकिंग केयर ऑफ योर सेल्फ एंड योर फैमिली मेंबर्स. सो यू आर वेल नोन दैट इन दीज डेज वी आर लर्निंग अबाउट ग्रामर, वी आर नोइंग अबाउट ग्रामर. अर्लियर वी हैव done two lessons. Today it's this is your third lesson about nouns and kind of noun. So in earlier classes you might have learned about the noun, that what is a noun, kinds of noun and all. So today also it's a revision part and I am just telling you about noun. What is noun? You know that it's a name of anything. Anything like pen, board, curtain, name of your mother, anything. Means whenever you heard about any name of any person, any place, anything, any animal, anything, that is what? That is a noun. So here see, noun is the name of person, place or anything. Here are some examples: Ramesh, boy, dog, Haldwani, river, etc. And there are so many more examples of noun. So it's important to know what are the kinds of noun. There are five kinds of noun. You know that common noun, proper noun, collective noun, material noun and abstract noun. Is it clear to you? These are four kind of noun. Is it clear to you? What is noun? Noun is naming words. Naming of words of what? Naming words of any person, any animal, anything, any river, anything. Name of a book. A book is also a noun. Name of the book is, you know that stories. So stories is also a noun. Is it clear? If you are a boy is also a noun. If your name is Ramesh, then Ramesh is also a noun. So, but here are five kinds of noun. What are these? So, it is, we must know what are these. So, I am going to tell you what are these: common, proper, material, abstract and collective noun. Okay. First kind of noun is common noun and second one is proper noun. As you can see that its name is common. You know what is common? That can be found anywhere. Common, very common. So let's see what is a common noun. Common noun is the name of common people, place or thing. All common nouns have plurals like boy, boys, girl, girls, toy, toys, city, cities. You know, kid, kids, dog, dogs. Okay. So whenever you find the name, it is common and it can have plurals like marker, markers, whiteboard, whiteboards, teacher, teachers, student, students. Okay, so these are common noun. As common noun has name is commonly. Okay, it's a kind of its own group. It tells about a group. Boy means boy. Okay. So this is common noun. Here are some examples. And what you have to keep in mind that a common noun has common name about people, place or thing. And it has its plurals also. Whenever you think that Ramesh plural is there. No. So it is not a common noun. Dogs, yes, it's a common noun. So it's a feature of common noun that it is having plurals. It's plurals. Whenever you find the name, you are having its there its plurals are there. It means that is common noun. Next one is plural noun. Sorry, proper noun. Proper noun is the name of a particular person, place or thing. Proper noun do not have plurals. not have plurals. And here all the common noun have plurals. Here in proper noun they do not have plurals. This is the difference between proper and common noun. Let's see, like Delhi, we can't say Delhis. We have only one Delhi, only one Haldwani, Ramesh, Deepthi, etc. Okay? Like if your dog's name is Bruno. So Bruno is a proper noun because it's a name of some particular thing of your dog. Okay? Let's see what is the difference between a common and proper noun. Okay? Here are some examples by which I'll explain you the difference between common and proper noun. Orden, progressive, school is the name of my school. Okay? So, Orden Progressive School is what? It's the name of a school. Your name, your school's name, my school's name. So, it's Orden Progressive School is a name of a school. There are not so many schools named like this. So, this is a particular name of a school. So, Orden Progressive School is what? A proper noun. It's a proper noun. Okay? And is the name of a school. School is what? School is also a noun. But here school is a common noun. Why? Because school can be, school has plural, like schools. But we can't, Orden Progressive School doesn't have its plural. Okay? So, this Orden Progressive School is a proper noun. School is common noun. Okay. One more example there. Rahul is my brother. Okay. In this sentence, Rahul is my brother. What is Rahul? A noun. What is a brother? It's also a noun. Isn't it? Rahul is what? Can Rahul a noun has its plural? No. Can brother has its plural a noun? Yes. So, Rahul is what? Rahul is a proper noun. Rahul is a proper noun and brother is common noun. Okay? And let me give one more example. India is the name of our country. In this sentence, India is what? Noun. Country is what? Noun. India hasn't its plural. Country has its plural. Country can be changed into countries. So here India is proper noun and country is common noun. Okay. Like Bruno is the name of my dog. Bruno is also noun. Dog is also noun. But Bruno has no plural. Dog has plural. So Bruno is proper noun because Bruno is a name of proper name. So Bruno is proper noun and dog is what? Dog is common noun. I think that by all these examples, it will be clear to you that what is a common noun and what is a proper noun. It's a very small difference between both of them, that common nouns always have they are they are plurals, and whenever the common proper noun nouns do not have their plurals. This is the difference. Okay, here third kind of noun is collective noun. As you can see, its name collective. Collective means when so many things are collectively at a place, that is we can say collective, like collection of pen, collection of so many things. So let's see, collective noun. Second, fourth one is material noun, and fifth one is abstract noun. Collective noun, the names given to people, animal, places or things taken as one unit are called collective noun, like class, group, team, staff, you know. So this way means whenever a word is given to a particular unit, you know, collection of something. So like class is what? A group of students. Staff is what? Group of teachers. Team is what? Group of players. So these kind of word are representing a unit particularly. So, and they are a collection within it, within the name of these things, like class, staff, team, isn't it? Gang, group. Okay, so this is collective noun. These words are telling us about a collection of some any unit. So these are collective noun. Okay, next one is material noun. As you can say, the name is material, means we can understand that something is there, material, something material. So let's see, nouns of substance, material or ingredients which are used for making things are called materials, material noun. Like material noun do not have plurals. Okay, like iron. You also never heard that iron, gold, steel, coal, water, isn't it? So these are the word which are telling us about material. Okay, like gold, steel, iron, water. Okay, and you can't find the plurals also. Golds, you never heard. Gold is gold, steel is steel, iron is iron, water is water. Okay, so whenever you have a feeling of after the name of these things that it is material, it is, we are talking about material, and they are not having the plurals, it means they are material noun. Clear? Next one and last one, fifth one, is abstract noun. According to me, this is quite different from other nouns. Abstract noun. Okay, the name given to qualities, emotions, ideas or things that we can neither touch nor see, called abstract noun. Abstract noun do not have their plurals. Okay, so what are abstract nouns? Abstract nouns, we can't see them, we can't touch them. There are some emotions, there are some qualities, some ideas, some feelings. Whenever we give to any idea, any feeling, any emotion, the name, these names are what? Abstract nouns, and they do not have their plurals. Keep in mind that material noun and this abstract noun, they do not have their plurals. Okay, so what are abstract noun? Like when we feel some emotion, like if we are sad, happy. So feeling of sadness, feeling of happiness, these are what? These are abstract noun. Can you see or touch a feeling? Can you see or touch the happiness, sadness? joyness. So these are what? These are abstract noun because they do not have their plurals as well as we can't see them and touch them. We can just feel them. So these are qualities, these are feelings, these are emotions. So whenever the word, the noun, it just tells about emotions, feelings, okay, and that is what? Those are abstract nouns. Okay, clear to you? Proper noun, common noun, collective noun, material noun, and this last and fifth one is abstract noun. Okay, and whereas about others we can see and feel. Abstract nouns we can't see, we can't feel them. So this is the speciality of abstract noun. These are feelings, these are emotions. Okay, so this is it. Here formation of abstract noun. You know what is abstract noun? Abstract noun is the name of like feelings and emotions. Okay, so how the abstract formation of abstract noun? So let's see. It can be formed by from common noun, from adjectives, and from verbs. Let's see how. Like, an abstract noun can be formed from common noun, adjectives, and verbs. Let's see from common noun. You know what is common noun? It has plurals. Okay, like partner. Part by partner. You know what is your partner? Your dance partner, reading partner, playing partner. Okay. Partner, partnership. With your partner, there is partnership of playing. There will be partnership of having meal, whatever. Next, boy. Boys, boy. Boyhood. You know boyhood? Next, child, childhood. Parent, parenthood. So these all partner, boy, child, parent are what? Common noun. So this way we can form the abstract noun by common noun. But like boy, boyhood, child, childhood, parent, parenthood, partner, partnership. Okay, clear to you. Next one is from adjective. You know what are adjective? Adjective are the words which modify noun or pronoun. Those are adjectives here. So how we can form that abstract noun from adjective? Like beautiful is what? The girl is very beautiful. This flower is very beautiful. Beautiful is telling about flowers. So beautiful is what? Adjective. So all these words given here, beautiful, cruel, proud, and deep, these are adjectives. So by beautiful, beauty is abstract noun. Cruelty is abstract noun. Pride is abstract noun. Deep, by deep, depth, it is also abstract noun. Okay, by this way, here is the formation of abstract noun by from adjectives. Okay, next, third one, from verbs. You know verbs? Verbs are action words. So from verbs, like verbs are whatever, you know, that hate, love. Okay, so by hate, hater, punish, punishment, please, pleasure, act, action. So this way we can form the abstract noun from common noun and adjectives and verbs. Clear? Here you can see that hate is a verb. Hated is a abstract noun. Punish is common noun and punishment is abstract noun. Please is a common noun. Please is a verb. Sorry, these all are verbs here. Hate is a verb. Hate, by hate, it became hater. By punish, it became punishment. By please, it became pleasure, and act is action. So this way, this is the formation of what? Formation of
abstract noun, from common noun, from adjectives and from verbs. Clear? Okay.
Students, you are seeing, watching on the board. Here are some words given here: color, fear, hope and taste. These are the verbs. While these are formed, these are changed and formed abstract noun into abstract noun. They are not changing. They will remain same: color, fear, hope and taste. Is it okay to know these are the words which will remain the same while these will be using as abstract noun. That time also they will remain the same. They are not going to change. Okay. So here last one is concrete noun. As a name concrete, you know, concrete is basically a mixture of some sand or pebble and some cement used to build house. That is concrete. Concrete means some hard material which can we see, which can we touch. Okay. So let's see what is a concrete noun. Concrete noun is a name given to a concrete object, like that is a person. That is, person is also a concrete object. We can touch oneself, a person, isn't it? Place or things or collection of things and materials which we can touch and which occupy space. Means whatever the thing or material or place which we can see and touch and which occupies place. Okay, that is what, that is concrete noun. Okay. So it can be a collection of things. Okay, it can be collection of things, it can be class, it can be stuff. That is also a collective noun, is also a concrete noun. Means all those kind of noun which we can see and touch will be come into this concrete noun. And basically, let me tell you that there are two kinds of noun, like concrete and abstract. Why? I have already told you five kinds of nouns, that proper, common, collective and collective and abstract. Okay. So why I am saying that there is basically two nouns, because there are five, earlier I told you five kinds of noun. That is okay. But basically why? Because abstract noun is a noun which we can't see, can't touch. It's a quality, it's a feeling, it's a it's a feeling. So we can't see the abstract, any abstract noun. It's a feeling. It can't touch or see. Whereas the concrete noun, concrete noun is a thing or name of a thing, place, okay, which occupies space, like this marker. It is occupying the space, no, like this whiteboard. It is also occupying the space here, and I can touch it. So what, both marker and the whiteboard, these are concrete noun, because I can see, I can touch, and both of these are occupying what? Space. Whereas I am very happy while I am teaching you. So happiness is what? It's an abstract noun. And I can't see happiness, I can't touch happiness. So it's a quality, it's a feeling of happiness. So that is abstract noun. And concrete noun, whichever the names of thing, person, place or any animal that can be seen by us, that can be touched by us, that occupies space. Those are what? Those are concrete noun. Means the thing that can be seen by everyone. Anything like book, haldwani, mountain, glass, bowl, spoon, fork, pencil box, your shirt, pants, shoes, anything.
which thing, the name of those things which you can see and touch and that occupies the space that is concrete noun. It can be collectively a class, a staff, a gang, a team. This is what? Collective noun. But why I am saying that it comes into the category of concrete noun? Because team, class, staff, these are, we can see and touch. Clear? So basically here are two kind of nouns. Okay? That is abstract and concrete noun. Both abstract and concrete noun are opposite of each other. Why? Abstract noun is a feeling. We can't see, we can't touch it. Whereas the concrete noun is, it's a concrete thing. It's a hard thing. We can touch it. We can see it. That's why both are opposite to each other. That's why I'm saying you that basically there are two kinds of noun, abstract and concrete noun. Except abstract noun, rest of the four noun is come into the category of concrete noun. Okay, clear? This is it, beta. And one thing more I am going to tell you, that today's homework is what? That you have to write in your rough notebook. I can ask you to show me in the Google Meet class. So everyone, it's for everyone, write in your notebook. By making a single sentence, you have to tell me the proper noun and common noun. More than two sentences, it can be two or three or more than that. Okay? And what you have to do, you have to give the example of concrete and abstract noun. Okay? This is your homework of today. This is it. So keep on smiling. Great day ahead. Be safe at your home. Okay, till then, bye-bye.